Lately on my channel, I've been focused on the Graviflyer. There's a reason for that. We're actually getting to a point where we finally understand how everything's built. I did a video the other day where I showed a simple picture, and I put Alexei's words in there, I translated them into English, and had a voiceover do it. Now, what was the importance of that? Alexei's actually telling you in there when he stops talking about all the other minutiae around him, he's actually giving you specific information about what he's looking for and how the Graviflyer works. I know a lot of you get caught up in the different inventors he looks at, and I've got a lot of comments about that. Well, I don't care about those inventors. It's not what we're looking for here. We're looking for how Alexei saw this thing. All the other inventors just give you an insight into his mind of what his train of thought was, which is great. But if you would just want to know about the Graviflyer, you don't need any of that. So what I did is I went back through it. I cut out all of it, and I just gave you his words. What you will find is he interchanges some words, but he means something else. High voltage generator means a Tesla coil. He doesn't exactly say it outright, but when you cut out all of the garbage every 5 seconds when he gives you a different inventor's name, you get to a certain point. There is beautiful information in this, stuff you will not find anywhere else. It's very important that you listen. So I cut out the garbage. I just gave you what it is he saw. And what I'll try to do is add a few visual aids to it this time, so that you can be walked through the process. He's telling you how he tunes it. He's telling you what he's looking for in tuning it. He's telling you if the circuits are important or can they be replaced. All of this information, when you're trying to reverse engineer something, is crucial to understanding the point. Then you take on top of it the inventors he looked at, and you get a mindset. But today, we're just going to look at his words, break them down, look at the parts of the Graviflyer themselves, and let's go ahead and walk through this. I think you're going to be fascinated by what was actually in this video if you just focused your mind and listened to his words only on his device. Let's get to it. It's a fascinating understanding.
The discs begin to form a field around themselves when we charge them with a lot of power. Mechanical rotation of the discs turns this field into a toroidal vortex. What prevents the vortex from getting dispersed? Each vortex has different potential. We keep the lower vortex charged negatively and the upper vortex charged positively. I used my middle disc to prevent the vortex from dispersing. I kept it charged with an HV generator. The charge is pulsating so that my two toroidal whirlwinds remain stable. The magnets attached to them increase the power. When charging the discs with high voltage currents, I experimented with the frequencies and watched the effect on the toroidal vortices. The vortices curled around each other and created two toroidal whirlwinds.
In less than 2 minutes, Alexei already described rotational force. He already described the polarization fields that he's having, positive on the top, negative on the bottom. He also explained how his Tesla coil is operating. He's also telling you about the fields and the toroidal fields that he's creating. So interesting. Less than 2 minutes in this video, and this is what he shows you. But there's more to come.
There are sound waves inside of electromagnetic fields. I mean, those waves create a certain effect. Two or more Tesla coils create interference between longitudinal waves, which could make a 32-kilogram object levitate. An electromagnetic field of a certain frequencies can create a particular environment where gravity is absent, while matter, time, and space change their properties.
So let's understand what he just said. Basically, we're creating a bubble, and we're using electrostatic charge along with frequency waves. Those frequency waves are blocking out the frequency waves that gravity holds. It's interesting when you look at the picture again. We see the bubble out there, and we can visualize electrostatically charging the actual craft, and we can say that the charge goes around the craft, But he's trying to say that the bubble on top and the bubble on the bottom are actually creating a bigger bubble when you put everything together. There's way more information here than the couple of lines that he used in the video. Now let's put it together. It's fundamental principles of how this thing works.
An electromagnetic field of a certain frequency can create an environment where gravity is absent. 2. An interference between longitudinal waves made by two or more Tesla coils neutralizes gravitational waves. 3. A fast rotating radial magnetic field creates a force which involves a vertical vector. 4. Sound vibrations of proper frequencies can make objects levitate. My Graviflyer is built on those fundamental principles.
Now that we have a simple understanding of what he's trying to do, let's go ahead and take a look at his blueprint here, and let's break it down.
Here's the impulse part with the HV generator. Here's the power part, and here's the low voltage part. Now we'll talk about each part and explain how they work. We need the power part to charge those discs with a high voltage current. Here we can see the regulator itself with a power supply unit. Here we got the current. Here we got the regulator. Here we got the power supply for the flyback transformer, although we can alter the design a bit too. It's not necessary to make it too complicated. A push-pull design based on two colors could work too. But I chose something quite simple. What does this part give us? The plus charge goes to the upper part. The minus charge goes to the lower part. This is connected to the fact that the Earth also has two polarities. The Earth is charged negatively, and the ionosphere is charged positively. Plus. Minus repels minus. A negative charge is repelled by the Earth. Magnets work according to the same law. Although the magnets don't repel each other here, we are getting something else. Why do we need the HV generator? We know that the HV generator creates an impulse for this transformer, but if we place a wire there, the impulse will get transferred to the middle disc via that wire. What results are we going to get with this? When the motors start rotating and we power them up with a high voltage current, what are we going to get? We are going to get two toroidal vortices. They are going to swirl in different directions. But this HV generator connected to the middle disc is going to prevent those vortices from canceling each other out. See, here we got the plus charge and here we got the minus charge. They can neutralize each other. As for the impulses they create, there is a constant impulse output, which creates a certain effect which prevents those two toroidal vortices from... What's the purpose of the ultrasound part? Here's the battery. Here's the regulator. Here's another one. And here's the ultrasound generator. I am getting an impulse from my HV generator, but my high-frequency waves are created by the ultrasound generator here. Here I installed some piezoelectric material. It's in the upper part of my disc. The entire design is quite diminutive. This model can fit in a cap, and all the regulators are taken outside the design. There's one low-voltage regulator with one wire in this model, but it has four cables attached to it. This supplies the power for the motors and this design above. Then, the power gets distributed between the motors and the ultrasound generator. The motors are responsible for making the discs rotate in different directions.
So far, we've cut out about 7 minutes of the original video and got rid of a lot of the mentions of everyone else. What are we left with? Well, we got a blueprint. We got an understanding of how to build this thing. All of that information was right there. Now, let's go ahead and take this to the next level. We need to understand how he saw his invention itself. So let's add a couple snippets in here of that so that you can get a realistic idea from this point forward exactly what he was looking at.
This piezoelectric emitter, it's been assembled as a part of the disc, creates enough ultrasound for this entire system. It radiates this whole apparatus with high frequencies. The HV generator also creates a high frequency impulse. Now we need to create a resonance with those parts of the design. We become subject to the law of centrifugal movement if the object doesn't shrink. That's when all the classical laws of physics work. The centrifugal force of the Earth will eject the object as far as possible. There are 6 magnets laid out in this manner. Why 6? Why not 4, 8, 9? Take a look. We'll get a honeycomb structure if we connect every dot within the circle. Add two longitudinal brushes, which got rid of the electrical charge during rotation and transformed it into electrons and positrons. The disks are rotating. Those two motors power two disks. Two toroidal vortices are created. The middle disk keeps the vortices from dispersing. It has a neutralizing effect, and gravitational waves envelop it. Why do we need this ultrasound part? Remember how Hutchinson experimented with longitudinal waves? He directed his emitter towards the objects and they levitated. The video mentioned how those emitters were projecting high-frequency impulses. An object would change its frequency properties once under the influence of those energies. This made them levitate. Any object also powered by electrons can lose its mass. What does this mean to us? It means that the Earth's gravitational waves are warped and circumvented.
Now that he's given us all the information, and now that we've put it together, let's take a look at the final design. What I tried to do in this video is just show you what he envisioned in his mind was going on with all of the different bubbles that he was creating and his Graviflyer. Hopefully now, with his final words in the video here, you can understand it for what it is. Let's take a look.
We need to harmonize the frequency from the HV generator from the middle disk with those toroidal vortices right here while keeping them powered up. Meantime, it's necessary to keep the disks magnetized and regulated because the condenser is getting electrically charged. If the charge gets too high or low, our parameters fail. So the gravitational waves pass through the system and collapse it instead of enveloping it. If we manage to synchronize gravitational waves in order to have those fields resonate with each other, those waves will end up circumnavigating the system, and the whole electronic model will work. This is how we can get this gravitational effect.
I hope now that you guys can see where I was coming from. All of this information, all of it lost between a bunch of words of garbage, but all of it's there. I hope you're absolutely fascinated like I am. I hope you learned something like I did. And I hope you can see things a little better. Sometimes you just gotta pause and listen to certain words because they have so much more meaning than you think you understand at that point when you initially watch something. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it. Like, subscribe, do all those fun things. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.